Western graduation gowns over traditional Burmese dress, fourth-year university students file into the auditorium for their graduation ceremony. This is Myanmar's oldest and most prestigious Western university, the University of Yangon. It was established in 1878 during British rule. And this is the International Theravada State Pariyatisasana University. Nearly all the students are bhikkhus. Guided here by Museum of World Religions founder Dharma Master Hsin Tao, he wanted to show both the faculty and students of the University for Life and Peace Experimental Winter School what a Buddhist university is like, theological yet diverse in its subjects.
Yangon大学呢，它是一个过去是跟 台大、北大是差不多的一种走向，对社会政治有影响的大学，现在状况是跟过去的状况多少让他们了解。佛教大学，缅甸是以佛教的文化为他们的核心的文化，也看看他们的教育，整个状况怎么样，深重的教育，扎实的这种教育啊。巴黎大学那学生是很有信心的，硕士、博士，一看他们那种稳定度就非常强。
This student is from a Burmese village. On his way to a temple to learn more Buddhist teachings, he passed through Yangon, and it just so happened that the State Pariyatisasana University was giving entrance exams. He decided to sit for the exams and passed. Before he knew it, he had finished college and is now in graduate school.
Buddhist literature or the teachings of the Buddha can make my mind at peace. So I like being a monk.
And this student missed the temple's entrance exam, so decided to take the university's instead. He ended up opening the door to a great new world of learning.
I took the entrance exam and I passed the entrance exam. So I became a university student. Most of the monasteries in Myanmar, they teach traditional Buddha teachings only, and not modern subjects like mathematics, English, and Myanmar literature, and computer as well. In Buddhist university, they also teach Buddhism, but more scientifically and more analytically. And then you also have to learn other about other religions, I mean Christian, Muslim, and Hinduism, Jainism, and Confucianism, and Taoism.
Compulsory education in Myanmar is only 5 years, and the quality can be rather unstable. A great deal of money must be spent for good education, which is difficult for most people to afford. When Hsin Paninda was small, his mother put him into the Buddhist education system.
I have no aim to become a Buddhist monk. When the government school was open, I have to go to the government school. In my holidays in summer, I have to go the monastery. When I was 7 years, there was some problem in my family, and then my mother, my son, go to monastery and became a novice. I'm sure you will have the chance to proceed your study. When I became a novice, I became happier. I became familiar with this Sangha society. Sometimes I want to return to live my life, but I think to myself, as a monk, I can do many social work freely, because as you know, in Myanmar, Buddhist monks have chance to educate people and to promote Buddhism, and then to help people more freer than people.
In Myanmar, monks are highly respected. Many are teachers, preachers, politicians, and even activists who in the past fought for democracy and independence. Burmese Buddhist universities combine religion and other academic subjects for a well-rounded education. Dharma Master Hsin Tao hopes that the future University for Life and Peace can transcend religion and through spirituality bring together subjects, faculty, and students from around the world. Though the main campus hasn't yet been built, the experimental winter school attracted top professors and fellows and was successfully completed, generating much curiosity and expectations of what the University for Life and Peace will become.